We're back. Hello, beautiful people, and welcome to Nightgowns Forever. Are you ready to fuck things up and scream your heads off from the safety of your home? I know I am. Yes! Get me some champagne. Tonight we are celebrating 5 years since the first Nightgowns show ever in August of 2015 at Bazaar Bushwick. To be honest, it was not the most crowded show, so this completely empty room feels pretty familiar, but it was good. The drag was good, the audience was loud. We could have easily kept on going out of sheer love of shows alone. Yes! Ooh, I need some champagne. Damn it. Our mission from the start was to put on a drag show that was respectful, authentic, dramatic, inclusive, creative, ahead of its time, and legendary. And now, 50 drag shows later, over 50 drag shows later, we still have never achieved that. But we are going to celebrate the progress that we have made and pledge to keep giving shows, keep showing up, Keep raising funds for our community and keep spreading the word about the beautiful art of drag. Oh my gosh, okay. I am getting a call from Miss Untitled Queen of the NightGowns cast. Let me see if I can add her in to join us.
Hi!
Untitled! How are you? Angel, look at you in
your red. I'm good. Oh, I know. I just thought I needed to call you up and I needed to pick up the red phone line and get you on.
Red phone and here you are. You look gorgeous. Welcome to the party, girl. Happy NightGowns anniversary.
Happy NightGowns. Happy 5 years.
To you too, baby. Oh my God, Malice and K.James.
Hey, babe.
Can you believe it's been 5 years?
Hi, angels. I can't.
We're so excited to celebrate with you tonight.
I'm so excited that you're here. You look gorgeous. Where's this phone from?
Oh, you know, just something we had around the house.
Of course it is. We have Mix Vander Von Odd joining us.
Hi, beautiful.
Hey, stunning demon of the night. How are you? Where's your telephone?
I tried dialing in from my old phone, but the connection was just terrible.
Too many people using the line.
Yeah, you know, ooh, dark. We got dark real fast.
There we go. Welcome to 2020. Oh, wait. Neon Calypso.
Hello, sister.
Hey, gorgeous.
How are you?
Good. How are you doing, Wonder Woman?
Oh, listen, I'm ready to turn up. Digitally, that is.
Digitally, safely, from a distance. The gorgeous goddess herself, Sasha Colby, is calling in, so we gotta add her as well.
My baby, my angel. Hi, angel.
Hey, boo. How are you, mama?
I'm doing good. I miss y'all so much.
Oh, we miss you too. You look gorgeous.
Well, thank you, baby. You too.
Well, now that we have the gang all assembled here, I think we got a drink to this digital connectedness to NightGowns. Despite all the limitations and restrictions, we will always make the drags happen. So I'm going to drink to that. And I'm so excited that you're joining me. Yes!
Fruity.
I'll do a toast.
Do it, Neon.
I would like to propose a toast to all of our people of color tuning in. You are all beautiful, you are loved, and your life matters. Cheers to tuning in NightGowns for 5 years.
Cheers.
I'll drink to that.
Cheers.
Cheers to that.
I'll do one. I'm in trying to get up. I want to give a toast to, I can't even believe it, 5 years of such an incredible, expansive family that we're going to be able to see tonight. And the amazing community building that's been going on, and the inclusivity and uplifting of stories, of our messages, of all queer people. So cheers to that. Love you.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Love you all so much.
I just want to say thank you all so much. I haven't been here the whole 5 years, but I feel like I have with the amount of like closeness that I've had with you, fam. And I really do feel that we are an amazing family unit, and it's exactly what we need to show the world. And I love you all so much. I love you guys. Happy 5 years.
Love you.
Love
you.
Happy 5 years.
I want to propose a toast to all of the kings, the queens, and the drag artists who found a home in NightGowns over the past 5 years and helped to make it the magical space it was. Here's to big dreams and to making homes for each other in drag. And here's to drag! Here's to drag!
To drag!
Love you.
Drag.
Yeah. I'll drink to that.
I'd like to propose a toast to all the beautiful things we've done in the past and all the beautiful things that we will do in the future. It's been 5 amazing years and I can't wait for 5, 10, 15, 20 more. As long as I can put drags on this body, I'm going out to the NightGowns and doing shows. So yes! Cheers to that.
You need each and every person in the community to make drag what it is. And I just love seeing that and love celebrating that too. So to the threads that sew us and bind us all together, to community and to beyond, love you all so much.
Love you. Cheers. Love you.
This is dedicated to the one I love. Voila!
do, especially for me.
Next, we have our angels of Nightgown, K.James and Vigor Mortis, performing their amazing number, the Chippendales number, and it was in September 2018.
I'm so excited to relive this act. K.James and Vigor Mortis are my favorite duet partners ever.
I'm so excited to relive it now.
Now give it up for K.James and Vigor Mortis.
This is impossible. Can't we just hire them both?
No. We've been through this. We've only got the budget for one dancer.
Yeah, but they're both so great, I can't decide between them.
Well, that's our job. That's what Chippendale pays us for.
I know, but these guys have been through hell. A 5-hour audition, 3 callbacks.
Well, look, if you want to give up your salary so Chippendales can hire both of these guys, that's fine with me.
Okay, okay.
Okay. Marcy, bring them in.
This is the part of the job that I hate.
Adrian? Barney? Listen, before we start, I just want to say once again that either one of you would make a fine addition to the Chippendale family. I know you've been put through a long, long audition, and it's been hard. But I think that in itself is a testament to how good both of you are and just how difficult our choice is. I wish I could just flip a coin and be done with it, but we can't. We're Chippendales. Marcy, music. Thank you, Adrian. Barney, if you could just give us a minute, we'll have our decision.
Oh, Adrian, you were great out there, man. I know, it's gonna be you.
Oh, what are you talking about, Barney? You got it, and you know it.
Whatever happens, you're the best.
Buddies?
Buddies.
They're ready for you guys.
Adrian, Barney, well, we've made our decision. But before we tell you, I just want to say once again how truly difficult it was for us to make our choice. And to thank you for your patience throughout this long, arduous audition.
Thanks.
We're going to go with Adrian.
I knew it, man.
Did you be? Shantae, you both stay.
Yes! Yes!
Give it up for K.James and Vigor Mortis!
Next up, we have the beautiful, the gorgeous, the stunning Sasha Colby performing Bohemian Rhapsody from December of 2018.
This is one of those ones, too, where Sasha Colby really, like, inhabits a character on stage and tells us a fucking story.
I remember 2 days before we were supposed to take the plane to New York to perform this show, Sasha Colby messaged me and she asked me where in LA she could find a straight jacket. And that was the moment that I was so ready for this number, so I'm so excited for y'all to see it.
Everybody, give it up for Sasha Colby.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see. I'm just a cool boy, I need no sympathy. Because I'm easy come, easy go, little high, little low.
Sure. Mamma mia, let me go. Beelzebub has a devil put aside for me, for me.
I'm so excited for you all to see this next performance. It is from the amazing Vander Von Odd, and it is their performance of Chasing Kites from the December 3rd, 2018 Nightgowns show.
It's just one of my, it's one of my favorite numbers that you ever did, Vander.
Give it up right now for Vander Von Odd!
Okay, up next we have the Dynamo Neon Calypso performing Triggertude from November 2017.
I love that Neon had the idea of live streaming directly from her phone to the projector. No one had ever done that at NightGowns before.
I wanted to do this in a live space, and now this is our livelihood of doing digital shows.
It's a live event where you are on your phone giving digital shows. And the audience was eating it up.
Okay, you are not ready for this, but we're gonna give it to you anyway. Please make so much noise for Neon Calypso!
I heard that when I write too many rhymes up in my lines so the intellect gets left behind. I heard I sound good, but I don't write good. I mean, write well, and well, hell, I've heard I wasn't ever supposed to be heard. That I'm from the South Side and I was born with a pussy and pussies were never meant to speak, they were meant to purr. They say I got a tongue born ratchet. Say the way my tongue fixed herself to say fuck you to your God ain't ladylike. My tongue don't come trim. It ain't primmed and proper how a classy bitch's tongue is supposed to be. My tongue is thick. I've heard it's more oppressive than a misogynistic dick. My diction ain't no Ivy League words of choice. I've heard my voice sound like children trying to play grown up. I've heard my voice sound like women trying to play grown up. It sound like I'm bitching. It sound like I'm a woman in a world who done lost her place and wound up outside the kitchen. You supposed to listen. You supposed to be seen. You ain't supposed to be heard. I heard my voice sound like the screech of a nigga's neck coming unhinged from the Lynch wrote my voice. Sounds like niggas singing and rapping and dancing and tapping in a hip-hop show. I sound too stupid, too poor, too black, too woman, too Charles Ramsey on Fox News, too Rachel Gentile in the courtroom, too Sweet Brown. Well, I had woke up to go get me a cold pop. Mouth stay steady, ready to pop off at anything that pop off my tongue. Is a trigger click, my mind is a grenade, boom. I stay with words that hit like bullets. My language pops a pretty packed pistol every time I preach. Every time I speak, my mouth is meant to blow you away. This is no dead fuse. This is no silence. I am not mute. I'm not meant to cookie cutter loud thoughts or carve down big speech. I don't give a flying fuckery about your comfort level. You will not chop off my tongue. You will not cut down my language or grammatically correct my ebonics. I am not hooked on your phonics. You will not claim me. You will not change me. You will not silence my screams or crack down on this truth. I am louder than this.
Brushed my hair, went downstairs. Favorite jeans on my rear. And I looked up in my mirror. And I said, who's that there? Who's that there? In that mirror. I don't care and they're aware. Now I see just why they stare. I just paid them, I don't care. I know. So what, I got an attitude. Bitch, I got an attitude. So what, I got an attitude. Bitch, I got a. I don't sleep, I don't snore. Too much money out that door. On my way to go to work. Bills too paid, so hit that dirt. Change up plans, then Juvenile came on. You know that's my favorite song. I was 15 minutes late. Because I try to be great, dancing on my feet. Your opinion, not today. They said, what's it gonna take? I said, I want a bigger plate. So that lady poured my drink. Then I went up on my rate. I could see the bitch was fake. So like Chopper, I escaped. And I told that hoe no. Like my ex, you got to go. I want all my money up front. If you don't, guess what? I'm gonna have an attitude. Bitch, I got an attitude. I'm gonna have an attitude. Bitch, I got an attitude. So what, I got an attitude. Bitch, I got an attitude. So what, I got an attitude. Bitch, I got an attitude. Attitude, 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 attitude. When they ask me where I've been, busy. When they ask me where I live, the city. I don't own a welcome mat. Give me the proper feet and stand back. I don't own a welcome mat. Give me the proper feet and stand back. Attitude, 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 attitude. attitude. Grace Jones, attitude. Pay rent, attitude. Or own home, attitude. Buffy Khan, attitude. Champagne, attitude. Khaleesi's God, attitude. So is Beyonce, 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 attitude. Khaleesi's God, attitude. So is Lakayla, attitude. So what, I got an attitude. Bitch, I got an attitude. So what, I got an attitude. Bitch, I got an attitude. So what, I got an attitude. Bitch, I got an attitude. So what, I got an attitude. Bitch, 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 I got an attitude. What?
Okay, so up next, I'm so excited for you all to see the incredible Untitled Queen performing Drunk Driver's Killer Whales
from February 2018.
I love Untitled's ability to sort of manifest poetry physically, and to see Untitled literally come undone on stage was really something beautiful to watch.
So without further ado, Untitled Queen!
Drunk drivers, drunk drivers.
your mind and perish the thought. There's no comfort in responsibility. Drunk drivers, drunk drivers. Doesn't have to be like this. Again, but you know he loves you and he doesn't mean to cause you pain. Please listen to him. It's not too late. Turn off the engine, get out of the car and start to walk. Drunk drivers, drunk drivers, drunk drivers.
Glorious Miss Malice performing Spooky from the December 2018 Nightgowns with skeletal backup dancers K.James and Vigor Mortis from the collective Switch and Play.
Sure, your little eye will be a-winking. Miss Malice. And her lovely boys, it's K.James and Vigor Mortis.
I am so excited to introduce this next number to you all. I remember being downstairs in the dressing room, looking at the screen and being like, is there silence in the theater right now? Is it quiet? I was like, I don't know what's going on. And I ran upstairs and came quietly through the back door and was in awe of this performance. Everybody give it up for Sasha Velour!
so careful with the way she held her spoon, kept away from the sun, always chilled to the bone. Only I'd keep her warm. I wonder now that she's gone, where did I go wrong?
This show is amazing.
Drag.
If you are loving it as much as we are, then please head to the NightGowns Venmo and donate any money that you are able to. We are raising funds tonight. 100% of the money we raise is going to benefit some very important organizations. And the NightGowns cast would like to tell you a little bit about the five organizations that we've chosen to benefit tonight.
Trans Justice Funding Project is a community-led funding initiative that gives grant money to grassroots trans justice organizations in the U.S. They help disperse resources to many organizations that need it. Every penny is redistributed to grantees with no strings attached.
The Brave Space Alliance is the first Black and trans LGBTQIA+ center in the South Side of Chicago. They have created and provide resources, special programming, and services for their community from within.
GLITS approaches the health and rights crises faced by transgender sex workers holistically, with a commitment to empowerment and pride in finding solutions from the community. Their work encompasses so much.
They provide crisis support and around-the-clock urgent care.
They advocate for health care and health resilience,
provide safe housing and referral information for trans people around the globe.
And not just for folks living in NYC, but also asylum seekers from abroad.
Hi everyone, I'd like to tell you a little bit more about For the Girls organization, which is a rent and gender affirming surgery fund that provides housing assistance and financial support for medical procedures. In their first year, they've raised over $250,000 and put it directly into the hands of Black trans folks, which is incredible. And if you are interested in seeking that assistance, you can reach them at GWORLS@gmail.com. Thank you.
The Ochre Project provides free, healthy meals, runs food workshops that teach cooking skills, and also provides COVID relief to Black trans people experiencing food insecurity anywhere in the world.
Head to the NightGowns Venmo. 100% of the money raised will go to the organizations that we've discussed.
I hate posting to no one.
I love the chaos. Next up, we have one of my favorite drag performers in the entire world. She is my sister from season 9 of RuPaul's Drag Race and is recently crowned as the All-Star winner. It is the incredible Shea Coulee giving her performance of Screwed from September 2018.
I remember being on the side of the stage and watching Shea Coulee and just being in awe of how powerful and commanding she was on stage. Every turn had a purpose. Every finger point had a reason.
Everyone give it up for Shea Coulee.
I live my life in a like Coca-Colas. Fake news, fake news, fake food, what's real? Steel in the matrix, eating on the blue pills. The devil met with Russia and they just made a deal. We was marching through the street, they were blocking every bill. I'm tired of hotels trying to tell me how to feel. For real.
My girl, Peppermint, coming up next, and she is doing Girl from the Gutter from our September 2017 show.
A fun fact about this performance is that Peppermint actually submitted the extended disco remix of this song, and apparently she didn't realize until after the track started playing, and instead of like stopping the performance or panicking at all, she just worked like every second of the instrumental and got the crowd in Skirble Center at NYU like screaming their asses off.
Knowing it now, it makes me appreciate it even that much more. That's incredible.
Seriously.
Make some noise for the incredible Peppermint.
Thank you.
a dancer, a rapper, an all-rounded, beautiful, stunning, incredible performer, Aja performing My Kind of Love from May 2017.
I think this performance was really, like, significant in NightGowns history. And this is such a vulnerable performance that I feel like kind of talks about the complex relationship that we have with RuPaul's Drag Race. I love Aja so much.
She is, you know, just one of the best performers I ever experienced. Yeah, love, love, love.
I want you all to give it up for the amazing Aja.
Oh, some light. Bitch, we're here at JFK Airport on, what day is it today?
August 8th, 2016,
with Dahlia, Candy Muse, Momo Shea, and Aja. Sick. Aja, where are you going right now?
I'm going to RuPaul's Drag Race.
Season 9, bitch.
My name is Aja, and I'm from Brooklyn, New York.
Your edges are officially snatched.
Yeah! Oh, yeah.
So, Jay just got back from LA. How do you feel?
I feel like a crazy person.
Look at you, you look crazy, but it's so cute. Oh my God, we missed you so much.
Oh girl, suck your stomach again, girl.
Suck your stomach again, suck your stomach again.
I don't have to, bitch.
No, we do, because we've been looking hot this past few weeks.
Yeah, because of Facetune, bitch.
Miss Cookie, oh, no. What you mean, first of all?
Sometimes the truth won't make you happy, so I'm not gonna lie. But don't ever question if my heart beats only for you. It beats only for you. No, I'm far from perfect, nothing like your entourage. I can't grant you any wishes, I won't promise you the stars. But don't ever question. Crying out when you're falling and can't be.
That's when you feel my kind of love.
Aja!
I am so excited for you all to see this number. This is Alexis Michelle, and this is her performance of It Was a Good Time from our September 2017 show.
Like, everyone knows what a great Liza Minnelli impersonator Alexis Michelle is, but this performance transcends that and is just like sheer acting genius. It like gets me every time I look at it.
I absolutely love watching Alexis Michelle do Liza. I mean, I just love a pantomimer, and I love it's the subtleties when you do an impersonation, and it's so important when you get like the little afflictions, or even like what I love watching is when she does like, it's not what you say, it's like the breaths you take to say what you're about to pantomime. That's so amazing to watch. It's so thrilling. Love it.
Now please give it up for Alexis Michelle.
I now pronounce you for the rest of your life. I now pronounce you man and wife. It was a good time, it was the best. It was a party just to be near you. It was a good time, it was the best time, and we believed that it would last forever. We would stay together and share the laughter with never ever a morning after. Such a good time. Since you've gone and won't be mine again, there are many stars that will not shine again. Except sometime deep in my reverie, you return and then I remember when. It was a good time, it was the best time. Party just to be near you. It was a good time, it was the best time, and we believe that it would last forever. Here we go round the mulberry bush early in the morning. Mama wakes up and she's alone, she's alone, she's alone. Mama wakes up and she's alone early in the morning. She looks a lot like him. Yes, she does look. Yes. My fair lady. Baby, baby, bunting. Daddy's gone a-hunting. Daddy's gone. Dormez-vous, dormez-vous. Mama will stay near you. Mama will be near you, not your dad. That's too bad. I believed.
you return and then I remember when it was a good time. It was the best time. It was a party just to be near you. It was a good time. It was the best time. It seemed a short time, but such a good time. A good
Alexis Michelle!
So you thought you were only going to get one Liza Minnelli number in a drag show? Of course not. This is NightGowns after all. It's impossible to have a favorite Sasha Velour number, but this one is certainly up there. Her performance of I Gotcha in June 2018.
Give it up for the incredible Sasha Velour. Coming up next, we have someone who very much inspired me as a young queer youth and who I admire very much. We have the incredible Amanda Lepore performing Buckle Up and Jean Genie from April of 2018.
Amanda Lepore has been an icon for 31 years in New York. How is that even possible?
Amanda Lepore is full lawless.
Kind of a down-to-earth lady, despite being a literal goddess.
She is a literal goddess. I was freaking out that Amanda Lepore was at NightGowns. I mean...
Please give it up for the flawless Amanda Lepore. Next, we have the living legend Lypsinka performing her Telephone mix from March 2018.
This was Lypsinka's first ever time in Brooklyn when she came to do this NightGowns performance. And when she stepped out onto the stage, we had to hold the show for, I think, over 2 minutes because of the standing ovation that she rightfully received.
I remember this night where I think I was on the balcony and you could sort of feel everyone like leaning even over it. And like everybody was so like wrapped, like ready to see this thing I've never seen in person. So it was incredible.
I think she really pushed the boundaries of what drag could be and invented a genre of drag performance with her distinctive mixes that is still carried on, a tradition that's upheld to this day. Now please give it up for Lypsinka!
Could see me now, that little gang of mine. Here in this fancy place, I'm gonna have a time. I'd like those stumble bums to see for a fact the kind of top drawer, first rate chums I attract. All I can say is, wow, we look at where I am. Tonight I landed, pow, right in a pot of jam. What a build up! Holy cow, they'd never believe it if my friends could see me now.
I've waited 20 years for this call. Now the mill can wait until I'm good and ready. How do you like that? The very idea of having some assistant call me, say I'm busy, and hang up.
Arthur, hi. No, nothing really, dear. I just wanted to hear your voice. It doesn't matter. Whatever you say is what I want to hear. I love you, too. I missed you so much last night. I waited and waited, and then I suddenly realized that you must be tied up in a meeting. You were home, but last night was ours. She did the same thing last week. How many headaches can she have? Arthur, nobody knows better than I do that you're married. Now you and your rabbit-faced wife can both go to hell.
Hello. I want to speak to Mrs. Janie Clarkson, please. Hello. Hello.
Hello? He's on the line? Let me speak to him. Mr. Liggett, I didn't think you'd be foolish enough to call today after last night, but since you have, face it, I was the slut of all time.
You'll be gone soon, and I'll be glad.
I wasn't being vicious, was I?
Hello? Hello.
Barbara, please. Please, Barbara. Leave us alone, Barbara. If you need anything, ask Carol Ann.
If they could see me now, that little dusty group, traipsing around this million-dollar chicken coop, I'd hear my buddy saying she must have paid a lot of loot to have that suit specially made. All I can say is, wow, wait till the riff and rap. See how they ask me now to sign my autograph. What a setup! Holy cow, they'd never believe it if my friends could see me now.
Hello. Hello, Janie. It's me. You didn't. You didn't. Why don't you die?
What a good idea!
You little tramp, throwing yourself at him, chasing him. Get out of here!
You come back here! Come back here, you! I haven't dismissed you yet!
You didn't. You didn't.
I may be the worst thing in the world, but I carry it in front where you can see it.
You're a liar! I heard you on the telephone. Now get out of here!
You didn't. Did you really? Peter, where did you see him? Dancing at the farmer's market. How gauche.
With a man over twice your age? Now get out of here!
And you were the one who was going to help me. Help me. Help me!
It's popularity we're all after. Love and friendship and laughter. We're all searching for something that will make us much more than we are. We want to live the life of a winner, like a cinema star. 'Cause you're on the top when you're popular.
I despise you!
It's popularity we're all seeking. Realistically speaking, it makes you feel so important. Just like a gent with a dollar cigar, you've got the lively drive of a golfer, kicking heck out of par. 'Cause you're on the top when you're popular.
Barbara, please! Please, Barbara!
They're coming to get you, Barbara.
I tell you, it's funny.
She's my daughter.
She's my sister. She's my daughter. She's my sister. She's my sister and my daughter.
It's popularity we all try for. We live and struggle and die for. When those fans hang around you, oh, then you know that you're bound to go far. You feel the happy glow when your chauffeur holds the door of your car. Because you're on the top, who can top you? Yeah, you are right on top, who can stop you? Well, you are right on top when you're above you.
Starting again. It's starting again. I'm getting nervous again. Oh, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know.
You should have died long ago.
I tell you for a fact, right here's where I belong, where I can do my act and go into my song. I hear my body saying, crazy, what gives? Tonight she's living like the other half lives. To think the highest brow should come to look at me, I wanna tell you now, it's you I'm glad to see. What a setup! Holy cow, they'd never believe it, they'd all agree. I'm in society. If my friends could see me now.
I have to say, this performance from Bob the Drag Queen has to be one of the most important performances I have ever seen. It's so beautiful, and it tells such an interesting story. Black Lives Matter, and they always have, and they always will, and that performance still rings powerful today. So thank you, Bob, for this beautiful number that everybody is about to see.
Give it up for the incredible, the hilarious, the powerful Bob the Drag Queen.
I dreamed that love would never die. I dreamed that God would be forgiven.
I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up, live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.
With their voices soft as thunder, as they tear the hope apart, as they turn your dream to shame.
I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that my four little children one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
And still I dream he'll come to me.
Little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today.
And dreams will hold me.
We'll be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual. Free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
But why did she have to use the Anne Hathaway recording of I Dreamed a Dream? That is the question that everyone wants to know. And Leah Salonga was right
Leah
there.
Leah Salonga, right there.
Thank you all for tuning in to NightGowns Forever. And for those of you who have watched the NightGown series on the Quibi app, thank you for supporting us. You have all seen the behind the scenes of what it takes to do one of these shows in person. And now you're watching a digital version.
Let's talk about NightGowns on Quibi.
Yes.
I just was so proud that how authentically it showed sort of the making and the process and the family that we call NightGowns.
That's the thing that I've heard so much feedback from. It's just the love that we have for each other. And it's so nice to have that saved moment in time.
I feel so proud of this show and so proud of each and every one of us for coming together and making it happen. Each and every one of you is such a fucking superstar, and you can see it in this show. And I'm proud to be a part of this, and I'm proud to know and work with all of you.
Official call.
We just got a call from Quibi and just got the official word that NightGowns has been renewed for a second season.
Oh my god. We're gonna be
superstars! That's amazing. Wow.
Reminder to please send money if you are able to the NightGowns Venmo. 100% of profits tonight go to raise money for a trans justice funding project, For the Girls, G.L.I.T.S. Inc., Brave Space Alliance in Chicago, and the Okra Project.
Up next, we have my blood sister from the royal court of the Boulay brothers, Dragula, performing a very iconic look of hers from the show. Put your hands together and grab your barf bags for the incredible, the disgusting Biqtch Puddin performing her filth performance from March of 2018.
I think it's the most like notorious performance at NightGowns. I feel like everyone that I knew that was there like immediately was texting me after, like while I was down in the basement. They're like, what happened? Is it real? Like they couldn't handle it. Like, I heard about it like weeks later, like people were like, but that number, but then like they can't, you know, get their minds off of it. It's perfect.
Shout out to Zoe Ziegfeld on the cleanup for this one.
I hope you are all ready. It's Biqtch Puddin.
When you're whistling? Oh, okay. Think the coast is clear.
Another.
Hold on, baby. We're moving just a little bit too fast. Let's slow it down for the children, okay? You gotta savor the flavor. Let's show them how to do things, Miss Puddin.
Yes! Zoe, we have a little cleanup. We need some help from you. Zoe Ziegfeld calling you, your only hope. Hey, girl.
Hell yes.
I want you all to get ready for West Dakota. And this is her performance of Show Me Love from our February 2018 show.
And when a performer is so really involved in believing their fantasy, it's impossible not to believe it with them. And in that sense, she's one of the most captivating people I've ever seen on stage.
Prepare yourselves and please make some noise at home for the one and only
West Dakota.
Change in the wind or a cloud. We were our ways, and you showed me love of the deepest kind, and I will never find another love like you showed me love.
Thing that we had, it was everything. Never thought we would be torn apart by a change in the wind or a cloud in the sky. We were always you.
West Dakota and her dancers.
so thrilled to introduce this next performer. We love to see her on stage every opportunity we can, and she gives so much to our community. Of course, I'm talking about the gorgeous, the beautiful, the powerful Zenobia.
And this performance is called Listen from November 2017.
This performance is so powerful and so heartfelt, and I love that that Zenobia has a policy of only performing to the music of other femmes of color, and always wrote in her bio specifically how important it is to uplift and support other people in your own community.
Please give it up for Zenobia!
Listen to the song here in my heart, a melody I start but can't complete. Listen to the sound from deep within, it's only beginning to find relief. They will not be pushed aside and turned into your own, all 'cause you won't listen.
Next, we have my bestie, babe. You know, I don't have enough time to tell you how much she means to me.
but she is the mother of Bushwig, and she is performing Selena's No Me Queda Más from December 2018.
She really is mother to all of Brooklyn drag, organizer of Bushwigs. She's so incredible, and this performance is stunning.
All right, everybody, put your hands together. Oh my goodness, give it up for our girl, Horrorchata.
All right, everyone, I hope you're having a good time. Let's keep it going and let's bring to the digital stage my girl Patti Spliff doing her incredible number called Pissin' in a River. And I think it's from her October 2017 show.
This is such a gorgeous performance, and I love seeing Patti perform to Patti Smith. Patti Smith.
Yes.
Please give it up for Patti Spliff.
Turn you back now. Let's talk.
Up next, we have one of my absolute besties, the funny, the talented Lucy Balls performing Don't Rain on My Parade from November 2017.
To have Carrie White meets Don't Rain on My Parade, this is what I'm looking for. Any Carrie act, you've already got me, like the ultimate in femme rage. Telekinesis, it's the dream, right?
I will also never forget her epic Babadook performance in the early days of NightGowns, which is still on our YouTube. Every time she's graced the NightGowns stage, it's been something very, very legendary.
Give it up for the incredible, the hilarious, the campy, the creative, the wonderful Lucy Balls.
Tonight at the Senior Throne, everybody is there, even Carrie White, the girl no one likes. The girl with her crazy mother. The girl with the strange powers. But tonight, no one will laugh at Carrie. She'll be voted Queen of the Prom. For Carrie, it will be a dream come true. For everyone else, it will be a nightmare. If you have a taste for terror, you have a date with Carrie.
On a motherfucking parade, okay?
Coming up, we have one of my favorite people to work with and someone I've been very fortunate to share the Nightgown stage with multiple times. Please give it up for Miz Jade performing Banji from Pride Gowns 2018.
She does numbers from every different genre, and I particularly love the amazing choreography that she put together for this performance with her backup dancers, Mary Angela Granberry and Eva Busta Move.
They move across the stage in such a way that is so, so powerful.
Please make some noise from home for Miz Jade. Next up, we have a performance from Pierretta Viktori, one of the most prolific drag designers out there, creating hundreds of costumes for artists from Manhattan, Brooklyn, Queens, Jersey, the Bronx, everywhere. Their work has appeared at Nightgowns many times before, on RuPaul's Drag Race, but they still have found the time and the creativity to be a fierce, radical, non-binary, black and white power clashing drag clown themselves. This performance of You and Your Hand premiered at Nightgowns in November of 2017.
Give it up for Pierretta Viktori.
There have been at least 700 cases of hateful harassment or intimidation since the election. Carter Evans has more of them.
Get out, going out on a late night. Looking tight, feeling nice, it's a cockfight. I
can tell. I just know that it's going down tonight. At the door, we don't wait, cause we know them. At the bar, six shots just beginning. That's when dickhead put his hands on me. But you see,
they'll let you do it. You can do anything.
Whatever you want.
Grab him by the pussy. I can do anything.
Shit, but you're going home alone, aren't you? Cause I'm not here for your entertainment. You don't really wanna mess with me tonight. Just stop for second. I was fine before you walked into my life. Cause you know when it's over. Before it begins, keep your drink, just give me the money. It's just you and your heels.
It's our absolute honor and pleasure to get to introduce this next performer, who's one of our oldest friends here in Brooklyn Drag, and our dear collective member in Switch and Play, and our drag sibling. They're an incredible poet, performer, pubic intellectual, wink wink, known as the non-binary verse top poet of Brooklyn Drag. This number is one of my absolute favorites that they've ever done. This is, of course, Pearl Harbor doing Do Re Mi
from New Year's Eve 2020.
Their contributions and their drag artistry are deeply written into the history of this show and this number in particular, which they performed at our last in-person get-together, really stands out, and it's really special to get to revisit it now.
Please give it up for Pearl Harbor.
Let's start at the very beginning. A very good place to start. When you read, you begin with
A, B, C.
When you sing, you begin with Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi. The first three notes notes just happen to be do re mi,
do re mi,
do re mi fa sol la ti. Oh, let's see if I can make it easier. Do, a deer, a female deer. Re, a drop of golden sun. Mi, a name I call myself. Fa, a long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread. La, a note to follow so. Tea, a drink with jam and bread. That will bring us back to do. Oh, oh, oh,
do!
A deer, a female deer.
Great!
A drop of golden sun.
Me!
A name I call myself.
Ah!
A long, long way to run.
So,
a needle pulling thread. La, a note to follow so. Tunes we use to build a song. Once you have these notes in your heads, you can sing a million different tunes by mixing them up, like this. So, do, la, fa, mi, do, re. Can you do that?
So, do, la, fa, mi, do, re.
So, do, la, ti, do, re, do.
So, do,
it all together.
So, do, la, fa, mi, do, re. So, do, la, ti, do, re, do.
Good.
But it doesn't mean anything.
So we put in words, one word for every note, like this. When you know the notes to sing, you can sing most anything together.
When you know the notes to sing, you can sing most anything.
Do,
a female ear, a drop of golden sun, a name I call myself. Oh,
Up next, we have the incredible dance and drag artist Francesca performing Genda from the first NightGowns at Sawdust in April 2017.
When she was studying dance and film in 2017, when she did this performance, all the other nights she came and helped us film and helped us edit and release the early NightGowns at National Sawdust. So her footage is one of the reasons that we can even do this show. Without further ado, give it up for Francesca.
75% of transgender New Yorkers have experienced harassment on the job. 20% lost their job, and a further 20% were denied promotion. 19% have been denied a home or apartment, and 18% have been homeless. 53% have been harassed or discriminated against in a place of public accommodation or service, such as a hotel or restaurant. 17% have been refused medical care. 75% of transgender children in K through 12 education have been harassed and discriminated against in school, and a shocking 35% have been physically assaulted. This piece looks at my feelings around finally getting out of a gender discrimination lawsuit. I worked at a gay restaurant in Hell's Kitchen, owned by two gay men. Was given a piece of paper stated that I was not allowed to wear eyeshadow or nail polish to work. Men. This piece looks at the fear, the frustration, the anger, the angst, the hurt that I was going through this. 2.5 years forced to be silenced. I'm a queer person of color, gay, gender nonconforming. Every day I wake up, I have a world that tells me I don't belong in it.
You do.
And we're getting, I want to get us to a place where we can all say that and live that and feel that. How do we move past self-hatred, self-loathing, femphobia, transphobia, homophobia?
Thank you.
Francesca!
We have arrived at a very, very special part of the evening. Elle McQueen was the very, very first special guest ever booked at a NightGowns back in August of 2015, and she joined us again at the National Sawdust Stage in June of 2018 for Pride Gowns with this incredible performance of Controversy.
She's just such, so stunning. Like her paint and like her movement, it's just really captivating.
Just so many beautiful memories with this incredible performer. And hopefully many, many more to come when we can gather again.
All right, everybody, give it up for Elle McQueen.
Controversy.
everyone. Rounding up the show, we have an amazing icon in New York City and for queer culture in general. Please put your hands together for Lady Quesa doing her powerful, most mind-blowing number I have ever seen. Spare Some Change for a Dying Queen. And that was in our September 2018 Nightgowns.
Quesa's been part of our Nightgowns family from the very early days.
She has been giving her lectures, her speeches, her empowerments ever since the beginning of her career. And I feel like I take away so many of the things that she has said in her speeches. She's always been like, what can you do for your community?
Please make some noise for Lady Quesa.
Buenas noches, buenas noches, everybody. My name is Lady Quesa'Dilla, and look at how far we have come. So here, I'm gonna give you some old school oral oration. So this is a monologue that Ms. Marsha P. Johnson used to say and tell. Can you spare some change for a dying queen, darling? I know I don't look like I'm dying, but I am. Us queens know what we're talking about because we're for liberation. Look at Stonewall. When I first arrived in New York City, all pressed and clean in white shirt and pants that my mother had bought me, I had heard about the Stonewall. So I thought I'd go over and check it out. And there were men dancing with men and women dancing with women. And all the way in the back were the drag queens, turning it out in gold lamé and wigs. So one night, I'm hanging out at the Stonewall with Miss June, who is feeling down, and she turns to me and she tells me, if the pigs come in here tonight and they bother me, ooh, honey. And sure enough, the pigs come in, and they come in, and they're pushing, and they're shoving, and one of those pigs comes in, and they push Ms. June, and they push her to the floor, and honey, one of those pigs, they scratch her face, and they pull her wig. Well, Miss Thing, there are two things that you never do to a queen. You know where I'm going with this, right? Honey, number one, you never, ever touch a drag queen's face. That's right. And number two, you never, ever touch the wig. That's right, honey. Never touch the wig. That's why when queens say hi to each other, we go like this. Right? Thank you. Thank you. Boundaries. So Miss June is on the floor, and Miss Pig goes to hit her again, and I yell, why don't you just leave her alone? And he responds, shut up and sit down, faggot. Now, darling, there are many things you can call me. You can call me a cocksucker. Me too. You can call me a queer. That's me too. But you cannot call me a bunch of sticks. So I'm trying to explain this to Ms. June and Mr. Pig, and before I know it, there are chairs a-flying, and there is just complete and total chaos. And before you know it, we're in the tombs. Again. No.
But that's okay. But yes, baby, yes, it's history. Look it up, honey. But that's okay, darling. And let me tell you, well, that's okay, honey. Because that's the beginning of gay liberation.
See, I was trying to make a goddamn point, girl. And everyone has done forgotten who did what and where and when and why. Oh, well, some of these blanquitos did. But it's okay. That's why we're here to remind you. It's okay. And sometimes I'll be walking by a gay bar and I'll see my gay sisters turning it out in all of their gay liberated glory, and I'll see a sign. No drunks, no dogs, no drags. But now it's no fats, no fams, no Latinos, no Asians. See, some shit never changes, right? 2018, and some shit never changes, y'all. We simply hold the mirror up to you all, right? I'm not calling out, I'm calling in. Calling in, right? Because if we wanna change, it's up to us to change. Now, absolutely, honey. Now, can you imagine comparing me to a dog? Right, girl? Well, I pay it no mind. Because once you 86 me, I tip. And once I tip, I stay tipped. And honey, they can 86 me out of every gay bar in the village. And honey, they can 86 me out of every gay bar in Bushwick. And honey, they can 86 me out of every gay bar in the world. And I don't care. Because I know who my friends are. I know who my friends are. My friends are the people who love their sisters. The addicts. Mm-hmm. The people living with HIV. Like myself. The people in the prisons. The undocumented children in cages. Because as we enjoy DragCon this weekend, which I want us to enjoy DragCon this weekend, let's remember that, right? Let's go about our lives, enjoy our lives, be productive citizens, but let's remember the fucked up things that are happening in our country, and remember what is it that we are doing for one another. Mm-hmm. So the next time, darling, so the next time that you see marginalized people on the street, I want you to dig down in your pocket. And that change that you're saving for your burger or your beer, honey, I want you to ask yourself, can you spare change for a dying queen, darling?
So very excited to revisit this special performance of
Jolene
from September 2018.
Jolene, 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 Jolene.
Thank you so very much for tuning in to watch Nightgowns Forever. Remember, drag is for everyone. Support independent queer art. Do the work to keep your community radical, safe, and inclusive. And please make some art to channel your feelings. Put on a wig, make a magazine, dance in front of a projector, whatever works for you, darling. Everyone can do it, and the world needs you. We love you so much. Have a fabulous night. Good night! Let's do an encore. I have one more number that I want to share with you. This one's something very, very special.
Now